Good morning, students. I welcome you all to the online teaching learning platform organized by our educational department of MCGM. Our today's subject is EVS 2, and the topic that we are going to take today is historic period. This is Ganesh Kedare from MPS Dharavi Kala Killa, G North Ward. Before starting our lesson, we will go through one good thought, that is, success is achieved and maintained by those who try and keep trying. Listen carefully. Success is achieved and maintained by those who try and keep trying. What it means? It means that we can achieve the success by doing the hard work and trying until we achieve our goal. So what we have to do? We have to do the work hard for achieving our goal. Then only we can achieve it successfully. Understood? Now, student, I am going to ask you few questions. Okay, all of you are ready? Say yes. Children, are you able to listen me? Okay. Now, students, can you identify this picture? Hello, students, can you hear me?
Yes.
Yes, very good. Can you identify this picture?
Sir, it is a boy.
Very good. It is a boy. And you are also, isn't it? A boy. Boy. Now, what is your name? You have a good name, na?
Yes.
Then tell me, what is your name?
Venkatesh.
Very good. Nice name, Venkatesh. Now, Venkatesh, tell me, do you like your name?
Yes.
Very good. Everybody likes their names, like me and you also. We all love and like our names. Now, observe this picture and tell me, what is it about?
A man.
Yes. A man. It is the picture of a
man,
an adult person. Okay. Now tell me, what is your father name?
Prashant.
Yes, very good. Your father name is Prashant. Okay. Do you like your father?
Yes.
And your mother? What is your mother name?
My mother name is Sonal.
Sonal. Okay. Very good. Now, identify this picture.
Grandpa or grandma.
Very good. Grandpa and grandma.
Grandma.
Do you have grandfathers and grandmothers?
Yes.
Okay. Then tell me their names. What is your grandfather's and grandmother's names?
My grandfather's name is Manohar. And my grandma's name is Shobha.
Shobha. Very good. Very nice. Okay. Can your grandpa and your grandma tells you the stories of their times?
Yes.
Okay. And grandpa usually tells the story to us and everyone. Okay. And that is why we love our grandpa and grandmas. And we love to hear their stories also. Of their times. Okay. Today we are using advanced vehicles to travel from one place to another place. Another. Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes.
Venkatesh, can you tell me which transport you are using to travel from one place to another?
Auto rickshaw.
Yes.
Or scooty.
Auto rickshaw and scooty. Okay. ऑटो रिक्शा एंड स्कूटी, वेरी नाइस। बट कैन यू टेल मी डिड यूर ग्रैंड पेरेंट्स टू ट्रैवल विद द सेम एट देयर टाइम्स व्हेन दे
नो
व्हेन योर ग्रैंडपा एंड ग्रैंड पेरेंट्स वेयर यंग दैट टाइम दे टू यूज द सेम व्हीकल्स दैट यू आर यूजिंग टूडे?
नो
नो दे आर दे वेर नॉट यूजिंग द सच टाइप्स ऑफ व्हीकल्स और एडवांस व्हीकल्स दैट वी आर यूजिंग टूडे दे मे बी यूज Which tools, which vehicles? Can you guess?
Bullock cart, horse cart.
Very good. Bullock cart, horse cart. They were using because there were no advanced technology at their times. Okay. Then how did you come to know this? That they are using bullock carts at their times. How did you know?
My grandma and grandpa tells me.
Yes. Your grandma and grandpa tells you about their life when they were young. Okay. Now tell me, identify this picture. What do you see in this picture?
Family.
Yes, it is the family. It is the family picture. There is you are also, your sister also. Can you read this?
Can I? Grandfather, grandmother, father, mother.
पिक्चर ऑफ अवर फैमिली एंड वी कैन गिव द हिस्ट्री ऑफ अवर फैमिली बाय शोइंग दिस चार्ट टू एनी वन यू कैन टेल अबाउट योर ग्रैंड फादर्स You can tell anyone others about that. Look at my father. He is my father. And how? What is his name and all? You can describe your family with this chart. Okay. And the same way you learn or you hear from your grandparents about their times and the stories of their times. What it means? It is nothing. It means that to knowing about their past events and stories is nothing. Grandparents, understood? To know about the event that gone by. To know about the event or the stories that gone by. The historic period. So, today we are going to study about our 10th chapter and the name of that chapter is historic period. The name of that chapter?
Historic period.
Historic period means the time of the history. The events happened in the past. To know about that period is the historic period. So today we are going to study about this chapter. All of you are ready?
Yes.
Okay. Students, what do you observe in this picture?
Food.
Food. Can you guess which food is?
In first picture, dosa, then urid vada.
Yes, yes.
Sambar.
Very good. And the next picture?
Next picture, rice, then chutney. Chutney, puri, bhaji.
थाली ऑल्सो यस पिक्चर इज अ मसाला डोसा एंड ऑल एंड सेकेंड पिक्चर इज अ थाली ओके द फर्स्ट पिक्चर दैट इज बिलोंगिंग टू द साउथ इंडियन पीपल्स दे आर इज साउथ इंडियन पीपल्स हैव देयर मेन फूड दैट इज मसाला डोसा राइस एंड ऑल एंड इन आवर महाराष्ट्र वी आर यूजिंग थालीज थाली इज फेमस इन our Maharashtra in that we use different types of sabjis different types of vegetables and chapatis and all understood
yes
now in this picture can you identify this picture
for Diwali Christmas Merry Christmas
okay
then
okay now listen The first picture that is about Diwali and below the Diwali there is a picture of Christmas. It means what is it? Can you guess? What is Diwali for us and the Christmas for us? What will come?
Christmas
is a festival or not? Diwali is a festival. These both are the festivals we are celebrating.
Yes.
And in the next two pictures, that is the clothes. Can you identify these clothes? What we call that clothes?
Gujarati and
Marathi. Yes. In the first picture, there is a ghagra, Rajasthani. And in the second
picture, Rajasthani.
And second picture, can you guess the costume? From which state it is belonging?
Maharashtrian.
Yes, it is belonging to the Maharashtrian. Okay, it is dhoti and kurta and sari. Okay.
Yes.
These all are the our costumes, our festivals. All these are we call it together. We call it our culture or diversity in our nation. Understood?
Yes.
So our first point is what is culture? What is mean by culture? Who will read this?
Can I read?
Yes, yes. One by one.
Knowledge of various arts, skills, and traditional inherited from generation to generation, and the way of life founded on that knowledge is what we call culture.
Very good. What is culture? The knowledge of various arts, skills, and traditions inherited from generation to generation, and the way of life founded on the knowledge is what we call culture. What it means? It means that generation to generation means what? From our parents to us, from your grandparents to your father, and your father to you. Understand? Whatever the knowledge, whatever the festivals you are celebrating in your, for example, in your family, you are celebrating the Diwali festival since so many years. Then how your grandfather was celebrated Diwali. Now after the grandfather, how your father started to celebrate Diwali. And after the your father, how you are celebrating the Diwali. There is a major difference. Maybe there is a time in at the time of your grandfather's time, there may be not a crackers, but today you are using crackers for Diwali. At the time of your parents, but they were using only divas, lamps, but now you are using different types of
lamps
and crackers. Okay, this is why this has happened to the generation to generation by giving the knowledge to one generation from one generation to the another generation, from your grandparents to your father, and from your father to you. And this is how the culture maintained in our society since many years. And maybe it will go in future also by you. From the next generation, you will provide this knowledge to your upcoming generation also. Understood? So I hope everybody is understood about the culture.
Now,
once again, I repeat this definition. You have to understand it. Okay, the knowledge of various arts, skills, and traditions inherited from generation to generation, and the way of life founded on that knowledge is what we call culture. The important factors that gives rise to any culture. Who will read these points?
Sir, I will read.
Yes, beta, you can.
First, art. Second, yes. Skills. Third, tradition.
Mm-hmm.
Way of life found.
Very good. Now, culture is depending on the four factors.
Arts.
That are, first one is arts. Second one is skills.
Skills.
Tradition.
Way of life found.
Very good. Now, I will explain you. In the arts, what is meant by arts? Arts means in the old age, people draw paintings in the caves, making pots. Isn't it?
Yes.
water makes the pots. After that, in the new stone age, what they started? They started to design that pots. They started to use the wheel also for making the pots. It means that it is the art. It was the art, and we are also getting some knowledge from them. Now, second one is the skills. What it comes? Skills is making the tools in the stone age, man making tools from the stones. After that, in the new stone age, what they started? They started metals to make tools and started farming. Okay.
Yes.
They are started using the celebrating the different festivals, and the way of life found means how they are living today or that time. What facilities were available in that times? These all are the factors. And after observing all these four factors, we can understood about their culture of these civilizations. Understood? To understand civilization and the cultures of that civilizations, what we have to observe? We are observing the four major factors. That is arts, skills, traditions, and way of life found. Now, students, can you observe this map?
Yes.
It is about ancient civilizations in river valleys. Okay.
Yes.
It is about ancient civilizations in river valleys. Now, in this map, you can observe in a yellow color ancient urban civilization. The name is given there, like Mesopotamia, Egypt, China, and Harappan civilizations. Understood?
Asia, African.
You notice there is a yellow color also in on the map. That is about the civilizations. There are four civilizations shown in this world map. The first one is Mesopotamia. Second one is Egypt. Third one is China, and fourth one is a Harappan civilization. Okay. Now, what is ancient civilizations in river valleys means? It means civilizations developed in river valleys are known as riverine civilizations. Do you know the about the valleys? What is mean by valleys?
No.
Okay. Valleys means the river flowing between two mountains or two hills. We call that valleys. Understood? So ancient valleys and ancient civilizations in river village, river valleys. We will see this. The major factors for rise in civilizations. Now we are going to study about the four factors about the rise in civilizations. Okay. Yes, yes, beta.
Major factors for rise in evolution. First, increase in production due to various skills. Second, the use of wheel. Third, flourishing trade. Fourth, use of well developed script.
Very good. These are the four factors that gives rise to civilizations. Okay, the first one is increase in production due to various skills. Now, we already learnt about the production, how the people started using production. They started farming. Okay, before farming, what they were using? They were using hunting for their livelihood. After that, they started the farming, and after growing the crops, they produce more food. So they settle down at a one place and form the village settlements. And after getting the settled there, there is a one civilization rose. Okay. Now the second one is the use of wheel. Okay. The second one is the use of wheel. In the ancient people, women started using pot by their hands only. We already learnt about this. After that, what they started? They started using wheel to making the pot. Means they got the skill. After getting the skill, they start earning. Our barter system is arose. Okay. And the third one is flourishing trade. The third one is flourishing trade. Flourishing trade is what? Development in a trade. Understood? Development in a trade. They started using different trades besides the farming also. And the fourth one is use of well-developed script. The use of well-developed script means the written proof is found in our history. In a new stone age or in the end of the new stone age, we found there is a written script, and this is the written script in the stone age, and the new age has been started. And by reading or by studying over that script, we understood about the civilization of any region. Understood? Yeah. The written book helps us to understand about the culture or any information about the civilization. Understood?
Yes.
Good. Now next is ancient riverine civilizations. The next topic is ancient riverine civilizations. What it means? Riverine means what? The civilizations that settled near to the river valleys. We call that riverine civilizations. Okay. These civilizations came into existence roughly around 3000 BC in the four regions of the world. They were as follows. Just we have seen in the map. Which they are? They are Mesopotamia, Egypt, China, and Harappa. These are the four civilizations that found our existence roughly around 3000 BC. 3000 BC means what? What is mean by BC? BC means before Christ. Okay. In the four regions. Four regions. Regions yani kya? The place. The area. We can call that a big area. Regions. A particular area. How many areas are there? There are four areas of civilizations in the world. All over the world. And they were as follows. The first one is Mesopotamia. Second one is Egypt. Third one is China. One is Harappa. Understood?
Yes.
Which are the four? Who will read these four?
Can I read?
Yes, beta. Only read the civilizations. Four. 1, 2, 3, 4. Wala.
Mesopotamia.
Yes. Egypt.
Egypt. China.
China. Yes. Harappa. Very good, beta. Very nice. Excellent. Now we will look after one by one each civilizations. Okay, the first one is we have learned that Mesopotamia. So what is mean by Mesopotamia? Mesopotamia is the name of region and not of any particular country. Now listen carefully. Mesopotamia is not a country. It is a region. What is it? It is a region or place. It is not a country. Okay. It means the land between two rivers. What is the meaning of the Mesopotamia? The meaning of the Mesopotamia is the land between two rivers. What it means? The land. Say.
Why?
Between two rivers. Okay. The ancient Mesopotamia was the land between the two rivers. Which are they? The first one is the Tigris and second one is Euphrates. Okay. Which are the two rivers? Tigris and Euphrates. Okay. These two rivers mainly flow through the Turkey, Syria and Iraq. From which country? These two rivers flows. These rivers flows from through टर्की, सीरिया एंड इराक. ओके, सो डू यू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज मेसोपोटामिया?
यस
वेरी गुड. मेसोपोटामिया इज द लैंड बिटवीन टू रिवर्स, एंड एंशियंट मेसोपोटामिया वॉज द लैंड बिटवीन द टू रिवर्स, टाइग्रिस एंड द यूफ्रेटस. अंडरस्टूड? विच आर द टू रिवर्स? द फर्स्ट वन इज टाइग्रिस एंड द सेकेंड वन इज यूफ्रेटस. इन बिटवीन दीज टू रिवर्स द मेसोपोटामिया इज द रीजन फाउंड. ओके, अंडरस्टूड? हैव यू अंडरस्टूड बेटा?
यस
गुड. नाउ सेकेंड इज इजिप्ट
इजिप्ट
सिविलाइजेशन. इजिप्ट इज अ सिविलाइजेशन. ओके, द रिवर, हु विल रीड दिस?
सर आई रीड
यस.
द रिवर नीले फ्लोस थ्रू द ईस्टर्न पार्ट ऑफ द
सहारा डे.
सहारा डेजर्ट इन द नॉर्थ ऑफ अफ्रीका वन ऑफ द एंशिएंट सिविलाइजेशंस फ्लोरिश्ड अलोंग इट्स बैंक्स इट इज नोन एज द इजिप्शियन सिविलाइजेशन.
वेरी गुड बेटा, वेरी नाइस, एक्सीलेंट. इजिप्ट, द रिवर नाइल फ्लोज थ्रू द ईस्टर्न पार्ट ऑफ द सहारा डेजर्ट इन द नॉर्थ ऑफ अफ्रीका. ओके, अफ्रीका इज अ कॉन्टिनेंट. ओके, एंड इन दैट कॉन्टिनेंट द रिवर नेम्ड नाइल फ्लोज थ्रू द ईस्टर्न पार्ट ऑफ द सहारा डेजर्ट. वन ऑफ द एंशियंट सिविलाइजेशन फ्लरिश्ड अलॉन्ग इट्स बैंक्स. वॉट इज मीन बाय बैंक्स? बैंक्स मीन्स द एज ऑफ द रिवर. विच रिवर? नाइल रिवर. द एज ऑफ द नाइल रिवर्स, एज ऑफ द नाइल रिवर्स देर इज अ वन सिविलाइजेशन दैट इज इजिप्ट सिविलाइजेशन. ओके, इट इज नोन एज द इजिप्शियन सिविलाइजेशन. वॉट वी कॉल दैट? दैट इज नोन एज इजिप्शियन सिविलाइजेशन. गुड. एंड विच रिवर?
नील रिवर.
नाइल. ओके,
नाइल.
नाइल रिवर फ्लोज थ्रू द ईस्टर्न पार्ट ऑफ द सहारा डेजर्ट. विच डेजर्ट? इट फ्लोज फ्रॉम सहारा डेजर्ट इन द नॉर्थ ऑफ अफ्रीका. इन द नॉर्थ ऑफ
अफ्रीका.
वेरी गुड. द रिवर नाइल फ्लोज थ्रू द ईस्टर्न पार्ट ऑफ द सहारा डेजर्ट इन द नॉर्थ ऑफ अफ्रीका एंड इट इज वन ऑफ द एंशियंट सिविलाइजेशन. विच इट इज मीन्स वॉट? वन ऑफ द मीन्स वॉट? इजिप्ट इज द वन ऑफ द एंशियंट सिविलाइजेशन. फ्लरिश्ड, वॉट इज मीन बाय फ्लरिश्ड? फ्लरिश मीन्स द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ द सिविलाइजेशन अलॉन्ग इट्स बैंक्स. ओके, द नेक्स्ट वन चाइना. द थर्ड सिविलाइजेशन इज चाइना.
चाइना.
नाउ आई विल रीड दिस. ओके, द एंशियंट सिविलाइजेशंस ऑफ चाइना डेवलप्ड एंड फ्लरिश इन द वैली ऑफ द हॉन्ग हे रिवर. विच रिवर? हॉन्ग हे. अकॉर्डिंग टू द चाइनीज ट्रेडिशन अ किंग नेम्ड हंगडी. वॉट इज द नेम ऑफ द किंग? हंगडी. हु इंट्रोड्यूस एग्रीकल्चर, एनिमल हस्बेंड्री, व्हील कार्ट्स एंड शैरियट्स, बोट्स एंड क्लोथिंग इन चाइना. हु इंट्रोड्यूस एग्रीकल्चर, एनिमल हस्बेंड्री, व्हील कार्ट्स एंड ऑल इन द चाइना? द किंग. यस, किंग. वॉट इज द नेम ऑफ दैट किंग?
हंगडी.
यस, हंगडी इज द नेम ऑफ दैट किंग. एंड द चाइना सिविलाइजेशन इज डेवलप्ड एंड फ्लरिश इन द वैली. कैन यू नेम, कैन यू गिव मी द नेम ऑफ दैट वैली? विच रिवर इज दैट? हॉन्ग हे. इन द रेड कलर आई हैव रिटन हॉन्ग हे इज द रिवर. इन द बैंक ऑफ दैट रिवर द चाइना सिविलाइजेशन इज डेवलप्ड एंड फ्लरिश. अंडरस्टूड? एंड द नेम अ किंग एंड द किंग नेम्ड एज हॉन्गडी इंट्रोड्यूस. इंट्रोड्यूस मीन्स ऑफ वॉट? मीन्स स्टार्टेड और गिविंग द इन्फॉर्मेशन. इंट्रोड्यूस मीन्स वॉट? गेटिंग द नॉलेज, यू आर गिविंग द इन्फॉर्मेशन और स्टार्टेड एनीथिंग, स्टार्टेड समथिंग न्यू. ओके, और बिगिनिंग, वी कैन कॉल इट द बिगिनिंग. ओके, बिगिनिंग ऑफ एनीथिंग. एंड हु इंट्रोड्यूस दैट? दैट इज द नेम हॉन्ग द किंग इन चाइना. एंड वॉट ही इंट्रोड्यूस? ही इंट्रोड्यूस एग्रीकल्चर. डू यू नो अबाउट द एग्रीकल्चर? सो आई हैव ऑलरेडी टॉट यू. एनिमल हस्बेंड्री ऑल्सो, Wilkar, Chariot Sports and Clothing in China. Understood?
Yes.
Now the last one is Harappa. Which is the last civilization?
Harappa.
Listen. Harappa, the earliest civilization on the Indian subcontinent is known as the Harappan civilization. Okay. Now Harappan civilization is from our Indian continent. Okay. It flourished in the Indus Valley. It flourished in the Indus Valley. Which valley? Indus Valley.
Harappan civilization.
Yes. Indus is the English word for the name of Sindhu. What is the Indus is the English word for the name Sindhu. Harappa in Punjab and Mohenjo-daro in Sindh are the two sites of Harappan civilizations to be discovered first. Which civilizations discovered first in Indian subcontinent? That is Harappa in Punjab and Mohenjo-daro in Sindh. Understood?
Yes.
Which civilizations discovered first? First one is a Harappa in and second one is a Mohenjo-daro. Is the first civilization, Harappan civilizations found in the Indian subcontinent. Understood?
Yes.
Good. Do you know about this Harappan? What is the aspect of Harappan civilization? That is, we are using in our house, we are having all the facilities like one room, two room, kitchen and toilets and latrines facilities. All these facilities we are having. But the same thing happened with this Harappan civilizations also. There is a cities of these civilizations are well known for their systematic town planning. Okay. The houses were built in a blocks created by the parallel roads that cross each other at the right angles. Like us, where like our houses also. There were also houses in the Harappan civilizations having all the facilities. Like there were bathrooms and latrines in every house and covered drainage system, which indicates a concern for public hygiene. Okay, it is the most developed civilizations among all the four civilizations. Understood?
Yes.
Good. Now it is the time for your evaluation. Okay, I am going to ask you a few questions. You have to answer these questions. Understood?
Yes.
Okay. Now first question, what is mean by culture? You can tell me in your own language also. What is mean by, what do you understand about the culture? What is mean by culture? Okay. The knowledge of various arts, skills and traditions inherited from generation to generation and the way of life found on that knowledge is what we call culture. Okay. Now second question, which are the factors responsible for develop any culture? There are four factors, I already told you. There are four factors. Which are they? Who will tell?
Skills.
Which are the four factors responsible for development of any culture?
Any culture, skills.
No, first one is the arts.
Arts. Second, skills.
Good.
Third, use of will.
And four. Life found.
Life found.
At that time. Okay.
Yes.
Good. Very nice, Peta. Very nice. Now, third question. What is mean by riverine civilization? What is mean by riverine civilization? The civilization that developed at the bank of the valleys or the rivers. We call the riverine civilizations. And that are four civilizations. First one is Mesopotamia, second one is Egypt, third one is China, fourth one is which one is the fourth? Who will tell? Which are the four regions of the world developed early civilizations? First one is Mesopotamia. Mesopotamia. Second one, Egypt.
Egypt.
Third
one, China.
And fourth one, Harappa.
Harappa.
Very good. These are the four regions of the world developed early civilizations. Okay. Now, students, it is time to your homework. Your homework is visit some senior citizens in your locality and collect information about the traditional sports and games of their times. What is your homework today? Visit some senior citizen. Visit some means what? We have to go to the senior citizen. Senior citizens means what? Grandpa, grandma is our senior citizens above the 60 years. All they are above the 60 years are the senior citizens. Okay. So what you have to do? You have to go there to them and ask them and collect information about what? About their traditional sports. What games they were using to play at their times when they were in a childhood or when they were in a their young stage. Okay. And the games of their times. Understood? Your homework. What is your homework today?
Yes.
Very good. Copy your homework now. I will give you 1 minute to copy. Copy it fast, or you can take the screenshot also.
Yes.
Okay. Write it fast.
I will take the screenshot.
Yes, very good, Veda. Excellent. Others too, write it down fast. And if possible, take the screenshot of this homework.
Yes.
Okay. Now, thank you, students, for attending the class. Stay home, stay safe. Bye bye, everyone.
Bye bye, sir.
Bye bye. Take care.
Thank you.